Good morning. We're interrupting programming with an update on COVID-19.
We're at 45.6 of our 16 and overs being fully vaccinated. And of course, it's when that milestone hits 70% that we're able to have those freedoms that we currently don't enjoy. Pleasingly also, 78% of 16-year-olds and over have at least one dose. And as we've said previously, we're really keen to see that first dose number be as high as possible before we open up to give us that extra level of coverage and safety. To 8 p.m. last night, there were 1,262 cases of community transmission, and regrettably, 7 people lost their lives, and we extend our deepest condolences to the loved ones of all those who've lost their lives. Again, we know that once someone has signed up for their first dose of the vaccine, the second one is guaranteed. And so Dr. Chan and I have said consistently, we really want to see that first dose go up as much as possible. So if you know anybody in your circle of family or friends who hasn't been vaccinated, please, please encourage them to do so. The sooner we have that coverage, the more confidence we'll have in what we can do moving forward into the future. As Dr. Chant will highlight, there has been some stabilisation in local government areas of concern, which is pleasing. However, the most concerning areas where the virus is picking up pace at the moment are in a couple of suburbs in southwestern Sydney, which Dr. Chant will outline, as well as some suburbs in the inner Sydney and inner western areas. Again, whilst we can look forward to having a much better life, much better freedoms at 70% double dose, we can't afford to let our guard down. We can't afford to not keep doing what we've been doing, because otherwise we will see too many cases when we open up at 70% double dose, and that's not what we want to see. We want to make sure that when we get to that 70% double dose figure, that we've managed to reduce our cases as much as we can to allow us to continue planning forward. And I'm personally very looking forward to when we get to 80% double dose and beyond, and that's up to all of us. So please, please encourage anyone in your circle who hasn't yet been vaccinated to come forward and get the vaccine. I'll now hand over to Dr. Chant for her daily update, and then we'll take questions. Thank you.
There were 1,262 locally acquired cases of COVID reported in New South Wales to 24 hours to 8 p.m. last night. There were no overseas cases. There were 105,505 COVID tests, so thank you to everyone who's come forward for that testing. There are currently 1,206 cases, COVID cases admitted to hospital, with 220 people in intensive care, 92 of whom require ventilation. Now, when we talk about those in ICU and the proportion that are vaccinated and non-vaccinated, it really is to emphasise the fact that we are in a very privileged position, that we have access to very effective vaccines and we know they work. And I just urge everyone in the community to come forward to their first dose and then follow that up by their second dose promptly. In terms of, sadly, the deaths, we've seen 7 deaths of people with COVID, a man in his 20s from Western Sydney, a woman in her 40s from southwestern Sydney, a woman in her 50s from southwestern Sydney, a man in his 50s from Western Sydney, a man in his 70s from southwestern Sydney, a man in his 80s from southwestern Sydney, and a woman in her 80s from southwestern Sydney. I just want to extend my deep sympathies to those families. Every time we read out a death, it is really the fact that that death reverberates through that family and the extended community. When we talk about the fact that people are dying, whether they're vaccinated or have underlying health conditions, it really is to highlight the fact that there are still many people in the community who are elderly and not vaccinated who have underlying health conditions. However, I just want to make the point that whilst you're likely to have more severe COVID if you're older and have underlying health conditions, even previously healthy people of all ages can get severe disease and die. So please do not be at all complacent. Go online now and book an appointment and get vaccinated as soon as possible. We have very good vaccines available in Australia, and we need to use these vaccines to protect us. I want to see 80% first dose next week, and I'm confident we'll get there around Tuesday or Wednesday. And then my challenge to the New South Wales community is let's get to 90% the following week. And let's also work across our most disadvantaged communities to make sure that no one is left behind as we strive to have the most equitable distribution of vaccine of any country in the world. And that's my aspiration. Thank you. I would also just like to highlight some suburbs of concern. Whilst we've had a strong focus on those communities in southwestern Sydney and western Sydney, we are seeing some little signs of hope of stabilisation of the case numbers in those communities. We are in turn seeing increases in cases outside those local government areas of concern. So in areas like Glebe and Camperdown, Redfern, Waterloo, we also are seeing some activity, high activity in places like Punchbowl and Wiley Park that are in the areas of concern. My message is please come forward to get tested and vaccination. Redfern Community Centre is a new COVID testing site and it's open 7 days a week from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. And as part of our mobile vaccination program, we've got free Pfizer vaccines are now available at various locations, including Wests at Ashfield Leagues, Green Square Library at Zetland, the Morris Yemma Indoor Sports Centre at Riverwood, and Club Burwood, and the National Centre for Indigenous Education at Redfern. So we're really very grateful to those people who have come forward for testing. That helps us block those chains of transmission. Please come forward for vaccination as well as we try and dampen down and suppress any transmission in those local government areas. But across the state, you need to be vigilant. We cannot be complacent anywhere. We are seeing also case numbers increase in Central Coast and Illawarra. In terms of our sewage surveillance, we've been detected fragments of the virus in Maruya, Port Macquarie, Trangie, Young, Brooklyn, Jarowa, Eden, Yass, and Karua, Tamworth, Dunbogan, and Dungog treatment plants. I'm particularly concerned by Yass, where we're seeing an increase in the level of the sewage detection. And so can I ask everyone, particularly in Yass, to come out for testing with the most minimal of symptoms, and please follow all the public health advice. Thank you.